Ooh, what's up guys? Welcome back to another Wyvern Battle from yours truly, not Skyrender, because I am Pokeplayer and today I am here to replace Skyrender for a Wyvern Battle because Skyrender is on vacation and I'm here to get his channel going a bit and upload a Wyvern Battle. Today's Wyvern Battle is an NU Wyvern Battle and it is a pretty darn good Wyvern Battle. You are going to see the Wyvern Battle from my perspective. And I led off with my Cream, my Muk, and he leads off with the Electifier. So I was pretty scared of this Electifier because it could have had Earthquake. I was quite certain that it would not have had it because I kind of know Squall. Squall, I already seen it before. But the best play is to go into my Rotom because he resists either the Electric type move and it is immune to the Ground type move. So I had to, no, I couldn't risk it. So now he goes into the Flareon because Flareon is bulky and on the special side, but I know I'm faster because I'm a Scarf Rotom and I Volt Switch out of there as my opponent takes that really nicely because it's a Flareon and Flareon is bulky on the special side. So now I go into my Quagsire knowing that I can probably take the possible fighter move, but he predicts it really nicely and goes for the facade and Quagsire is not able to take that, but I am rocking the Rocky Helmet. And that means that if he goes for another one, he is going to go down for quite a bit. But I am a bit stally and I go for the Protect right here just to stall out his burn and to check what he was going to go for. And I saw that he was going to go for the Flare Blitz, but I thought I should make a good play right now as well because I know he's not going to go for the Flare Blitz again. And I again went into my Rotom, which was the perfect prediction because he went for the facade. So there was some cool mind games going on between our two. He predicted my Quagsire switch and I predicted his facade. And right here he goes into the Torterra as I go for the Shadow Ball because Shadow Ball was the most safe play. He didn't have a normal type on his team, I believe, and he still had the Torterra in the back, so I couldn't risk it. So now I go to my Smexy, my Eviolite Surfine, which is nothing to mess around with. You guys should definitely watch out for that thing. And he goes for the Rock Polish and Stone Edge. And Stone Edge does not a lot of damage. And I do miss my Leaf Storm, which is kind of unfortunate because it kind of did matter. Because as you guys can see from this Leaf Storm, it almost takes it out. But the second Leaf Storm would have definitely taken him out. So that was pretty annoying. But right now, I switch out because I do want to preserve this guy as a death fodder or for something later. And I knew that he was going to go for another Stone Edge. And my Hitmonchan does resist that, so that's perfect. So right here, I'm not sure what I went for with the Hitmonchan. Let me see, he went into the area though, and I think I just went for the Mach Punch just to play it safe because he did have the boost and I was not able to outspeed him with those boosts. And he had the Aerodos, which was the perfect counter. I was planning on putting Fire Punch on there, not predicting the Aerodos, of course. But Fire Pulse is just some good coverage at some time. So now I go into my Muk, knowing that I am immune to the possibilities of Toxic. And I have seen this Aerodos before, so I kind of know his set, which is not really fair, to be honest. But I knew that he runs Toxic. I know his full set, but it's a really cool defensive Aerodos. You guys probably saw it on his channel. Of course you saw it on his channel because it's pretty darn good. So now I'll go for the curse, trying to set up a bit because I had no reason not to do it. I know I couldn't touch the Aerodos, but if I set up enough curses I was able to get past it. So now after the curses my opponent goes for the knockoff and he knocks off my Black Sludge, which is a good move because now I have no means of recovery anymore. And I go for the Poison Jab, and how much damage does it do? It does not enough, but I do score the Poison. You have a pretty darn big chance of scoring a Poison with Poison Touch. Poison Jab, Muk, it's a 60% chance I believe. So now he goes for the Waterfall, he still does a good amount of damage and I did know that he would die at this point, so I set up another curse. And if he didn't die, I still had the Shadow Sneak in the back, so that was the best play that I could have made right here. So now he dies from the poison, of course, because poison is a well, it can be annoying at some point. So now he goes into the Meltdown, the Flareon, and I kind of knew that the Quick Attack was coming, but I didn't really want to risk it to switch it to Rotom because it was still a pretty darn good Mon to keep around, so I decided to just go for the Shadow Sneak, but I knew that he would outspeed me and go for the Quick Attack, so it doesn't really matter. But now I go to my Rotom, because I'm able to full switch out freely. No, I go for another Shadow Ball because Grimlock is still around and I couldn't risk him going switching in because that would have been too risky. So now I go in for the Shadow Ball and it does a good amount of damage. And it does kill him, of course, because Torterra doesn't have the best special defense and it was at a low amount of HP. So now he goes into Zeratul and I still want to preserve this guy. I could have gone for the Shadow Ball, but I went into my own Malamar at this point, because I run a special move which I really like. But he predicted this. I don't know. Yeah, no, I don't think he predicted this. I'm not sure what he did. But he made a double switch predicting a Pokemon to come in and actually predicting a Pokemon to live a hit. So that's a really good play of his. But I do run a special move on my Malamar to stop his own Malamar, and that is the move Topsy Turvy. I will explain it in a bit, maybe. But he goes for the Facade and I didn't really need my Surfine anymore. I preserved it as a Death Fodder, and here it's really useful because Meltdown is going to die from the poison. But Topsy Turvy reverses the stat boost. So if, for example, Malamar comes in and he goes for a superpower and I use Topsy Turvy, he will have, instead of plus one attack, plus one defense, he will have minus one attack, minus one defense. So that's a really good counter. So right here, it goes for the Hidden Power, predicting me to switch out, I think. I'm not sure, but I just went for the superpower because I knew I could take it. I'm a mixed bulky Malamar and not that much investment in attack. I'm probably more invested in HP, defense, and special defense. And I go for the superpower because I know that I can do a lot of damage. But right here, he goes for the Thunderbolt and he does score the paralyzation, which is annoying. But it is pretty annoying, to be honest, because I get paralyzed a lot of times. But right here, my opponent goes for the Volt Switch and my Malamar does live this pretty nicely because Malamar is a beast. And to be honest, the speed drop doesn't really matter, but the paralyzation is annoying at some point. So right here, I went for a knockoff because I know it would have killed the Electrifier, and he has some Pokemon left who doesn't like the knockoff. So he goes into the area though, knowing that it can wall me out, and he goes for the Nightshade, and it does not kill me because I have 2 HP left, but I get paralyzed, which was annoying. Once again, paralyzed. Oh man, paralyzation. It can be such a dick at some point. But my opponent sets up the Sticky Web because he knows that that could be useful at some point. But I get paralyzed again. And Skyrunner is such a cool guy. Definitely subscribe to his channel if you didn't already. And he goes for another Sticky Web because he feels bad for all the paralyzations, which is really nice of him, because that's fair played, of course, because the Hex was really not in my favor at that point. But I am paralyzed and I'm not at a good amount of HP left, so this Malamar is not really a threat to him anymore. So he goes into his own Malamar and he goes for a knockoff, and that is enough to kill me. Of course, I did went for the Topsy Turvy just to play it safe right there. So now I go into my Quagsire, which is really useful because it has the ability Unaware. And Unaware, as you guys probably know, means that stat chase, that he doesn't care about stat chases. So he can superpower me as much as he wants, but it won't help. So right here, I go for the Recover because the health is always useful on a Pokemon. If you don't have health, you will lose. And I do switch out right here because I kind of knew that he had Hidden Power Grass and I did not want to die at this point. So I go into my Hitmonchan because Hitmonchan is bulky on the special side. I know Hitmonchan can take the hit pretty darn good. And he actually goes for the Volt Switch right here. So he predicted my switch really nicely. Skyrunner made some pretty darn good plays and we both made some good plays. It was a really intense battle. But now he goes into the Zeratul, and because the Sticky Web was up, I know that I'm not faster, so I have to go for the Mach Punch, get some extra damage off, and it still does a great amount of damage, to be honest. So my Shinchan goes down, my poor Hitmonchan, and he gets the boost, but at this point it doesn't matter anymore. I still have 2 Pokemon left, as Skyrunner has 2 Pokemon left, but I have 1 Pokemon left who can wall one of his Pokemon really nicely, which is the Quagsire. At this point, it doesn't matter what he goes for, because he will die at some point. So he goes for knocking off my Rocky helmet, which is cool because now I can go for the Scald. I was hoping for the burn, and can I get the burn right here? No, I cannot get the burn, which is a problem. And he goes for the Psycho Cut. He knows superpower is weaker because it doesn't work with the unaware. And I go for another Scald, hoping for the burn, and I still don't get it. He goes for another Psycho Cut, and I was playing it safe because I didn't want to lose the battle, so I went for another recover. It was probably very unnecessary, but still, you always gotta play it safe, because if something goes bad, you regret that you didn't play safe at some point. So now I go for another Scald, and it still doesn't kill him, and I still don't get the burn. I should have gone for the Earth Power right there, probably. It would have taken him out, and it was a better play. And I go for another recover. I should have just Earthquake, to be honest. I mean, Earth Power. I run Earth Power on this set. So he goes for another Psycho Cut. He's actually hoping for the crits, but he doesn't get them. And I go for the Earth Power. And his last remaining mon is the Electrifier. And he does have the Hidden Power Grass, I think. But he might have overpredicted at this point. He probably wanted to kill the Rotom because he predicted me to switch into that. And he went for the Thunderbolt. But it doesn't matter either way. He would not have been able to win either way. But that was an amazing battle against Chris Skyrunner. Make sure to check him out. Check out my channel if you like my voice. And then I'll see you guys in my next Derated video.